prospecting, and they are suspect, prospect, lead, and customer. And as you can see on this slide, point number one, everybody is a suspect. All right, so that's everybody you know, everybody you meet, they're all suspects at that point in time. Point number two, once they show an interest in what you're talking about or what you're promoting, then they become a prospect. From that point on, that prospect has to be converted to a lead. So this is your presentation, this is your overcoming objections, all that sales technique goes into the movement, conversion of a prospect to a lead, and then the lead becomes a customer once they have booked with you, they've traveled, and then they've returned and booked again, and hopefully it referred someone to you. So that's the process. So what we need to do now is get back to the suspect and turn them into a prospect. Let's go and do that right now. You can see on this slide that I've created a Wordle, a word cloud, a Wordle it's called, and I've actually enhanced it to show you just what is actually pulling people's eyes, hearts and minds to travel trade marketing. And photography, images, photographs are big, huge, and so part of your prospecting plan should include photography, your own preferred, or the images and the photographs from your preferred suppliers. Now, larger than photographs, you see the word referrals, and of course this is always a number one method of prospecting, but of course you have to have a steady list of clients before you can ask them for referrals. So, as you build a client base, you continue to prospect, and you prospect, the best way would be to prospect would be through referrals. And then, of course, all the other terms and words on this word cloud indicates various methods for which you can then continue to prospect. So we've got social media, as you know, and we've also got the 5-mile radius around where you live. There's a niche market, and so on. All right, so you've got dozens and dozens of ways to market, to get the word out, which in turn would be prospecting. So let's look at the 3 points. We've got number one, prospecting is like panning for gold. You never really know if you're going to strike it rich. So there needs to be some sort of mechanism for whether or not you've got a response. But panning for gold is, once you know where it is, then of course you can start to dig. So once you get a hit on anything that works for you, you focus on that and you go for it. Point number two, you want to choose your preferred prospecting tool. So what is it? What works for you? Which leads me to point number three, how much can you actually invest in your prospecting, in your marketing? Very, very key. If you do one ad in a community newspaper and leave it at that for the month, then you are not going to get any prospects, any leads, any suspects calling you. But if you invest $1,000 within 3 months, you might get a response. You can also do your email marketing, which is relatively free to do if you're just going to use your email program. But if you buy into a program like Constant Contact, then you're going to have to pay at least $15 a month for up to whatever it is, 500 or 5,000 emails to be sent. But there are email services you can use and start to prospect. There are also email lists that you can purchase, but they don't tend to work out. They usually have a lot of duplicates, and many times you'll be spamming people. So with the new spam laws coming in, you don't want to be doing that. So here we are. We're back to this slide, and photography is number one. Oh, sorry, referrals is number one. Photographs and videos will be number two and three. And you've got to work out how you can take yourself to market through those elements, all right? Photography, videos, and of course, if you do have a client base, referrals. So let's move on to the next slide. As you can see on this slide, we have a great slogan at the bottom. Somebody sell us something. And this is a truism. People want to be sold something. But in the travel trade, since we've gone from telephone to email, and email to website, to social media, we've gone very passive on the art of prospecting. And that means that we're putting marketing pieces out there, we're putting emails out there, we're sending out this, we're sending out that, but with very little strong call to action. We're not being very committed to asking for the sale. So this is something you have to decide what you're going to do. whether you're going to be prospecting passively or assertively. So those are the two things you need to think about. Let me take you to the three key points. Number one, what is your preferred client profile? Do you know the people, the person, the client, the suspects that you're looking for? And who are they? Where do they live? What do they spend? Where do they go? What does all this information tell you that you might have access to as to the profile of the client that you prefer to do business with? Once you know that, you can start looking for them. You can start hunting for them, prospecting for them, and you can start to target how you market. Point number two is, what is your niche? So what kind of business are you into? If you're trying to, as a home-based agent, sell everything to everybody, you're going to have a challenge. You just can't do it these days. There used to be a time when a generalist was the key way to go, but now you should be a niche specialist, niche market specialist, perhaps with a little bit of general travel around it to pad the commissions, i.e. you need to sell something, because your niche won't always be hot this week. But you need to decide what your niche is and then go for it. Now, if you're going to go into the adventure market niche or the golfing niche or the corporate travel niche, then you can target market, you can target prospecting as well. But if you're all things to everybody out there, you've got a challenge. Point number three, who lives within your 5 mile selling radius? Now, this is old media marketing. The 5 mile selling radius has been with us an awful long time and nothing has changed. Now, you may be on the internet with your website, you may be on social networks, maybe two, three, four, or five, and that may take you worldwide, which of course it does, but you cannot sell worldwide. The only way you can sell is by selling to someone in front of you on the phone by email that wants what you've got, and most of those people that will do business with you are located within your 5 mile radius. Yes, I know there are many travel agents who sell someone in Europe or the UK, etc. Maybe clients have moved away and still doing business with you via the internet, via email, etc. But for the most part, most ICs, most home-based travel agents selling from a home-based office are selling to people within their community and within a 5 mile selling radius. So you have some decision making to do. Let's go through it again. You've got to be a little more assertive in your prospecting. It's got to be targeted, which means you must know your preferred client profile. They should be matching your niche market, whatever that is. So if it's golfers, if it's women that golf, if it's women that go fishing, if it's family travel, whatever it is, whatever your niche is, that's how you start to target your prospects, your suspects, generate them into leads. But everything has to match. If you're scattered, nothing's going to work. And then back to point number three, whoever you contact, whatever your niche is, you should be able to fulfill that niche market within your 5 mile selling radius. All right, I'll let you click to the next slide. This is our final slide, and let me take you through eight key points. So first thing you need to do is choose your niche. That will save you trying to market everything. Next, as mentioned on the previous slide, you have to profile the niche client, the person that's best suited to the niche that you are selling. You're going to find out where they get their news. This is very, very important. Where do they get their news from? Where would they read about travel? Would they go online? Do they get a local newspaper? Or are they into magazines? You've got to find this out for sure. And on point four, then you have to get between them and their news. So if they're online, if they go to websites, you've got to start marketing your website. From your website, they'll find information. From that information, they'll get a call to action, and then they're going to make the call or send an email. So there is a circle that's going on there, but you have to get in between them and their news. If you know the statement I've used many times, whoever owns the news wins, that's what I'm talking about. Point number five, strong call to action statements, whatever they are. We don't mean aggressive here. What we mean is it's got to be something that pulls that person towards making a call or sending an email. It could be a price, it could be time defined, it could be anything. It's as long as it's of value to them and they've got to call now, they've got to email now, they've got to do something now, and you have to tell them what to do, that strong call to action will start to get response. Your suspects will start to become a prospect. Local consumer events, this is one of the best ways to go. You can see my picture on the right standing up presenting. That's what I do for a living. don't, you can learn how to do it. It is not difficult. All it takes is practice. So if you can stand up and be in front of a crowd of 20 to 50 people, you can do a local consumer event once a month if you're up for it, and you can present whatever it is you're going to present and market. It could be related to your niche, and you could just do a stand-up storytelling event, or you could put a slideshow together, or you could invite a BDM from your preferred supplier. But this has to be focused on you. It's all about you. It's not about the BDM. It's not about the preferred supplier. You have to develop this prospecting base that hopefully will turn to leads and customers. So it has to be you that's delivering the consumer event. Don't forget that. Point number 7, if you want to sell further afield to the next state, next province, so around the world or wherever, then you can start to use online presentations and webinars. If you learn how to do that, you can tap into the internet for sure. The key word there is practice. Point number 8, email is the number one method for prospecting, marketing, generally staying in touch for the travel trade and almost every other business. One way to do it is to just use text, so just type it out and send it. So, dear whoever, I have a special on cruising, a special tour, I've got a special something, and the deadline for booking is, we'd love to have you go with us, love Steve. All right, so that's just a paragraph of text. The other way, and the more professional way, is to use templates, and these are ready-made. You can sign up with someone like Constant Contact, and again, it will charge you something like $15 a month for the basic program, and there you have access to ready-made templates that you can then just fill in the blanks, add in the photograph, type your text in, add your logo, and then you can also collect email addresses, and you can manage your contacts right within the Constant Contact program. So email remains the best. All right, so I'm going to leave that with you now. I hope that helped. This is a training page in IC Travel Agent. So come back next month because there'll be another one. Thanks so much. Steve Crowhurst signing off. And all you got to do now is make money. Bye for now.
Wanna shimmy, shimmy, shake. You make me wanna shimmy, shimmy, shake. You make me wanna shimmy, shimmy, shake. Shake and bake, bring and spin me.